Hello guys, I'm going to make a video series for basically guide on round 2 in LAN battles. So it will be kind of competitively focused, so might not be the most interesting thing, but I hope I will help a lot of people with this video series which want to get into round 2 competitively. And maybe just improve in LAN battles. So let's start with the Nomads. So this video will be about the Nomads, of course. Next video, for example, will be about Eastern Greeks, like Pergamon, Nabatea, might throw Carthage in that, Colchis. Other video will be about Desert Kingdoms, except Nabatea, because Nabatea is a lot worse than the other Desert Kingdoms, so I don't really want to put them in the same category. Then about Greeks, then about Barbarians, and yeah, should be interesting. So the Nomads, they basically do the same thing, and the playstyle is basically the same. Use Draco, get quick charges, get out. Try to waste the enemy ammunition by dodging archer volleys. Even though if the enemy has singers, it will be really, really hard to do that. But singers take a lot of time to set up, so if you can surprise them, you can probably counter them that way. But yeah, it's really, really hard to dodge singer fire. So let's see the factions. So Royal City focus on Missile Calf, Masagete focus on Cataphracts, and in my opinion, Cataphracts are just the best calf in the game. And Roxolani focus on cheap units with the Draco ability. So depending on the rules, different factions are the best Nomads, basically, because if there are no rules, if you just, I don't know, no artillery, then you can go with Royal City and destroy pretty much any build in the game. Like, you can basically beat everyone with this build. You only have to have some kind of decent micro, and even if you don't, you just focus far with 10 horse archers on one singer, 10 horse archers on an archer or something, destroy the enemy skirmishers in a couple of volleys, and then use heavy shot on everything else, and that's it, you win. I mean, there aren't really a lot of counters to this build. Actually, I don't think there are any counters. Maybe just corner camp with some artillery like scorpions and then elite skirmishers, and you don't even need pikes really. And their missile box chance is shit, maybe like shield bears or something. And yeah, this build is kind of like complete cancer because this build doesn't even require a lot of skill, if any. And yeah, you just focus far and that's about it. With some rules like max 4 missile calf or max 6, Royal City almost becomes worthless. And then Masagete and Roxolani start to shine. So Masagete can hard counter Royal City with this build. Royal City just cannot win. So the Cataphract horse archers, they have 90 armor, 95 health, so if you don't really kite a lot with the City on Amazonia riders, you're just gonna get wrecked. And even if you do, the Cataphract horse archers will just push you to the red line and focus fire on the lancers or on the City on Rogue horse, and you lose again. So yeah, With 4 or 6 max missile cav, Rositia just becomes a really poor faction, in my opinion. Mainly because of this overpriced cav. Meta cav in general is pretty bad in Rome 2, especially against infantry. And yeah, this unit is way too overpriced because Sarkatrax, as I said, the best cav in the game, is actually cheaper than these guys. And you have to bring them because of the Draco ability. If you don't use the Draco ability, it will be really hard for you to win as the Nomads. And yeah, this is basically Rositia. No rules, absolute god faction, nothing can even touch them. With rules, just pathetic. Even Pergamon can beat them. I don't know about traditions, but yeah, even Pergamon and like the worst factions can be Rositia. Yeah, so it kind of depends on the rules. So let's continue. Masagete. So Masagete is a great faction. Can be quite fun. So you can either go this, like elite horse archer spam, or you can go with these sack artifacts. So you can also bring these step armor lancers. I really like them. It is a must to bring these Mercy Amazon riders, maybe with one step horse archer. And we have 1370 left. Can bring this guy, or can bring some of these guys. Then 640. Let's see. Yeah, I'm not really sure what more to bring. Maybe one more step noble lancer, and then one more step armored lancer. So it's kind of 5 of the same sort of build. But you kind of need Draco, so you kind of have to bring this guy. Even though I don't really like this unit at all. I mean, just compare the stats, 100 health to 120 health, a lot of melee attack, but not a lot of charge bonus, worst defense, but yeah, you really need a Draco ability. And yeah, this pretty much Masagete basically get nice charges with the Sack Artifacts, cycle them, and yeah, that's pretty much it. But I don't really like them, basically because of this unit. I think Roxolani are more competitive and are generally better, because this unit is not really expensive. Yeah, cheaper with 40. Sure, is not Cataphract, doesn't have the super heavy mass, as you can see, only very heavy, but that makes them a bit faster, and 80 charge bonus, that's insane. Then 110 health, 110 health for a unit that is not Cataphract is again insane. 46 attack, 90 armor, everything is good on these guys pretty much. They also have encouraged, don't have disciplined. This guy have the, actually no, they don't. Yeah, strange. Maybe cavalry don't have the discipline trait. Yeah, I don't know. So these guys are insanely good. So let's compare the charge. So Saba, let's see, Saba only 68 charge. Let's see the Macedonian Companion Cav, only 76. And Epirus, only 76. So yeah, the Sarmatian Royal Lancers have the highest charge bonus in the game. So that really means a lot when you're playing as the Nomads. So you can use them quite effectively. And I think Roxolani is also the laziest faction, of course, if there are rules. So you bring some of these guys, of course, as the Masegete, because the Martian Amazon riders are limited to 3, so you kind of have to bring Step Horse Archers. So maybe some of these Sarmatian Horsemen, but a lot of these Sarmatian riders. Some of these guys, and then maybe one less. And then, yeah, here's a full army. So you have 4 units with the Draco ability, 4 Horse Archers, 4 of these Step Noble Lancers, 3 Step Armored Lancers with Step Lancers, and then 3 Sarmatian Roll Lancers. I'm actually saving this. Also 4 Horse Archers. And yeah, Masegete is kind of hard because you're relying on pretty slow cav units, and you have only one unit with Draco, which yeah, I really don't like this unit. And as you can see, Roxolani can bring far more units, and Roxolani also has 3 elite shockcav. Oh, sorry. So 3 shockcav. Masegete has 4, but not a lot of additional cav units. And these calves can remove all bones versus calf on these answers. So yeah, I think Roxolani is the best and kind of most balanced nomad faction, because Masegete rely heavily, like extremely heavily, on the Catrefax, and to bring something else only against Raw City, to be honest, and maybe against Partia or Armenia or something. Yeah, against any other faction, Masegete will spam side Catrefax. And Raw City is even more heavily reliant on the City of Noblewomen and the City of Amazon Riders. But yeah, I have a replay for you guys, which is a 44, which I played on a stream of a fellow YouTuber. So it's showcasing Masegete against Raw City. So Raw City went with 3 Elite Melekav, 6 Armored Lancers, 3 Noble Lancers, and 4 City of Noblewomen. I went with 3 Mercenary Amazonians and 1 City of Horse Archer with a Chevron, because it improves the fire rate. Actually, where is it? So let's do a slow-mo. So yeah, here it is, Step Horse Archers, and let's see. So yeah, it improves the shots per minute by a little bit, and it's not that expensive, so it's kind of worth it. But chevrons in round 2 are generally not worth at all. So sack Catrefax, I've got 3 of them, and on the flank. So I'm going to use them in case the enemy decides to charge my Horse Archers, and in case I forget about them, so I can kind of save them. Let's see, actually I have 4 sack Catrefax. Yeah, that's quite a bit. I have 4 Step Noble Lancers, I have 2 Step Lancers and 2 Step Armored Lancers, and I spread my guys all around the battlefield, because the way you use nomads in team battles is basically you deploy behind your teammates, and when they're about to charge or when the enemy is charging them, you use your calf to interrupt the enemy's charge, so your teammate will get a clear charge and will do a lot of damage, which is true for Lustani probably the most, because Pontus doesn't really have a lot of char bones, like 18, and then the Torx Horse with their 18. So yeah, and I'm trying to skirmish a bit with the Amazonians, and this is a huge mistake what he's doing. I think he's a bit too overconfident in the abilities of these City and All women, but because there are medium mass, I have light mass, I can easily dodge the missiles of the City and All women, so it's not really a problem. As you can see, I haven't even got a single loss, and I already killed 6 of his. So yeah, this would be a bit of cat and mouse here. And even though these guys do have quite nice armor of 35, here I kind of fucked up, but I'll get a lot of kills. Here he'll get 1 kill, yeah. And 2 losses here, 8 here, 5 here, and 0 here. And it's also a mistake to use precision shot, because it will tire your guys a lot. So now it will be even easier for me to dodge his arrows. And yeah, he's losing men like crazy. So I'm going to go in range and try to get even more kills, moving the step armored lancers on the flank. Here, let's see. Yeah, I managed to again dodge his volley, so it's pretty easy to dodge with light calf against medium calf. And I'm winning decisively the skirmish engagement here, even though I have really shit armor, like 10 armor against 35. So yeah, the enemy is advancing, Sparta is... I don't know why Sparta is there, to be honest. Sparta should be here on the flank, because I won't be able to touch Sparta, because yeah, he's kind of boxing here, which is weird. Yeah, so the army compositions don't really matter here, but it's kind of interesting to see two armored desert chariots for Massey City. But yeah, Royal City is basically trying to do the same thing as me, but it just won't really work for Royal City because he has a lot of this melee calf and doesn't really have a lot of good lancers. So yeah, it just won't work. Even though I have all my sac artifacts here, I have a lot of lancers and I'm moving a lot here as well. And Pontus is also supporting Luzdani, so this flank will be pretty easy for us to win. And it's all because Sparta basically kind of fails. And yeah, here it's kind of showcasing how to exploit the singers, how slow they prepare to fire. So I killed like 30 of them only with a single volley of 2 or 3 horse archers, and imagine what would happen if I had like 10. So yeah, but I would prefer if you guys never spam horse archers. I mean, 4 to 6 is fine really, but more than that, it's just cancer. It's just complete cancer. So Sparta is finally moving here, but they shouldn't have moved there really. They should have engaged Pontus, because now Thales is fighting both Massilia and Pontus at the same time. And Numidia will fight me, Lusitani, and Pontus. So pretty weird decisions. So I'm gonna charge the Celtic Warriors here, which is actually pretty good for Massilia. So he'll get a clear charge with the Celtic Warriors. As you can see, already 30 men down. So Step Lancers did pretty well, even though they were more like a mid shield. So Armored Numidian Riders getting destroyed by the Balearics. Kind of weird that he's letting him, and even weirder than that he's just charging here. He shouldn't really charge here, because they are Scutari spearmen and he has zero units here to support. So even if we weren't here, I mean Pontus and my calf, and this would have been a pretty terrible engagement for Numidia. So let's see here, nothing really happens. Pretty ballsy charge by the Massilian calf, but a lot of blobbing here, so should have charged here. But nice dodge from Massilia. Probably was unintentional, but yeah, whatever. And here, letting me shoot at the step armor lancers is not really ideal. And I kind of missed the charge here, but yeah, I charged with the step noble lancers, which caught both the heavy Numidian skirmishers, the Numidian light calf, and the desert legionaries. And now Luzdan is charging. The chariots would try to do something, but they won't be able to, because if they try to, I'll just charge them. And yeah, they're already losing units, and they're not that great of a unit to begin with, so now they start dropping. So the Draco removes a lot of the Volver Sludge, but still 10 and now 50 because of the cavalry counter tactic. So yeah, even if you use Draco and the spears use cavalry counter tactics, is still 50 Bolvar Sludge, which is pretty huge. So I'm using my step armor lancers to deal some damage on the Nova Horse, while the Gully Hunters are focusing on these two units. So the step armor lancers are getting wrecked by my Horse Archers, and let's see. Yeah, the chairs got absolutely destroyed. And now these lancers are getting wrecked as well. Sparta, I don't think Sparta has any idea what he's doing. Thales. Yeah, Thales engaged Massilia, but Pontus, almost nobody engaged Pontus. And my cav is still alive, as you can see. And they're pretty healthy, so I lost like 10 guys and we routed Massilia or Numidia. I kind of prefer to call them Numidia. So let's see, the City of Noblemen are now in melee, which is kind of weird. I really doubt they used all their ammo. So I got a lot of these cataphracts. I have no idea why I'm going into melee, probably pathfinding issues, because I didn't really click a melee order, just a shoot order, but it's fine. So the step armor lancers, I think, were thinking about charging the Gully Hunters, but now I'm just gonna charge them with a unit of step lancers and some cataphracts, and these guys are just gone. So, recharging tribals here, recharging desert legionaries, charging the city and rogue horse, and yeah, Numidia is just gone. Oh man. My voice is not really doing well, but yeah, let's continue. So, Sack Artifacts, this was a really poor charge, but he's kind of pulling through my guys. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, he stopped. Let's see. Sparta is running in phalanx. I have no idea why. Kind of funny. And yeah, this flank is completely routed. And we took almost no damage. Lusitani just destroyed Numidia with our support. Yeah, Tuor spears are still alive, and most of the Lusitani units are still alive. And the tribals are dying to my step noble lancers, even though my step noble lancers will soon die. But it's still worth it. So I'm gonna retreat here, trying to kill the city of noblewomen, because that will be kind of annoying in late game. And yeah, this is pretty much over. No reason to war this, because it's pretty much over by now. The chariots didn't even engage, and I'm gonna destroy all the skirmishers. As you can see, Sakat Fax 100 kills, 1 loss. And yeah, now I'm just focusing Sparta. Kind of terrible micro here, getting into melee with Sparta. but yeah, it doesn't really matter at this point. So yeah, this is basically what you do in team battles with the Nomads. 1v1 is a bit harder and a bit different, because most players would just disable Pharah tool and then dodge the enemy missiles for like 10 or 20 minutes straight, which is really boring, and to be honest, kind of hard to do, but still really boring. And yeah, 1v1 is a lot harder. Here, if you basically have even minimal synergy with your teammates, you're going to make this work. So, as you guys can see, Royal City got absolutely shredded. And I did relatively well. I lost only 300. And I lost half my Step Noble Lancers. Lost my one of my Step Lancers, and got my Step Armor Lancers relatively damaged. But yeah, Sakat Fax, look at this, 215 kills, not even half strength. And this unit with the Chevron, 60 kills. These units didn't even engage, they didn't have to. So for Royal City, you can see that nothing really worked, not a single unit worked for Royal City. And yeah, you can see how effective this is. So Desert Legions, Desert Cohorts. But this is funny, look at the Armored Desert Calf, 1 kill, then 2 kills, then 3 kills. I mean, it's a progress. Here again, 2 and 3 kills. Yeah, it's just really effective to use Nomads in this way. Just lead the charge for your teammates, but if your teammates refuse to charge, well, that's another thing and might get really annoying, I guess. But yeah, Nomads are great in team battles. In 1v1, they're kind of hard, probably for veterans, not really for new players, because dodging missiles with horse archers can be really tricky to do, and you really need to run at the right moment, or the enemy missiles won't start to shoot, or they'll hit your guys. So yeah, you really need to practice that a lot until you manage to do it well. And I can do it well, kind of, not perfectly. As you saw, I got my horse archers kind of hit, but I didn't really suffer massive casualties. I think I lost like 5, maximum 10 men against the city and no women. So yeah, I hope this video will help you improve your skills with the Nomads, and I hope you have fun, and most of all, I hope that you're not going to bring the cancer of 20 horse archers. So, thank you guys for watching, see you in the next video, bye bye.